Hey, yeah. Welcome back to Release Radar. I'm Chris Biscardi, and today we're going native with Parcel and SWC. Parcel Beta 3 indicates that an official roadmap for the stable release is coming soon, so I'll put off talking about Parcel as a whole and instead talk about the specific changes that are in Beta 3. But if you don't know what Parcel is, we have to do a quick overview. So first, what is Parcel? Parcel is a bundler, which means it's in the same space as Webpack, ESBuild, and Rollup. The biggest difference between Parcel and the other tools in this space is its batteries included approach. While Webpack and Rollup can make you feel like you need a million plugins, loaders, and a degree to set up a config, Parcel comes almost pre-configured by comparison. That's not to say that Parcel is singularly monolithic like ESBuild was when it started, since it still contains a usable plugin system. But it is more usable from the get-go with no config and aims to be more zero config than other tools are. Most existing JavaScript bundlers are starting to move towards marketing themselves as compilers rather than just bundlers, and Parcel is no exception. This reflects the ever-increasing scope of a JavaScript bundling tool, and it's no surprise that Parcel is also taking this path. Let's stop for a second and talk about versions and releases. Parcel 2 Alpha 1 came out in 2019, Parcel 2 Beta 1 came out in 2020, and today we're talking about Parcel 2 Beta 3, which came out in 2021. Now this might feel like a long time to have not shipped a major release, but if you compare this to some other projects that do major version releases with breaking changes twice a year over the last 5 years, I personally don't really have an issue with them taking the time that's needed to ship this. Having built projects on top of faster moving and more breaking libraries in the past, it's actually a huge pain and prevents you from shipping more features in your higher level libraries because you're always dealing with the underlying breakages. By sticking to a major version release for so long, Parcel has ensured that this doesn't happen to your projects. Now onto the big changes in Beta 3. The biggest change, in my opinion, is the implementation of SWC inside of Parcel. This is a replacement, but actually lives side by side with, the Babel implementation. Historically, bundlers like Parcel have done a lot of work to optimize Babel, as it can be one of the slower parts of the compilation process, and it often happens a lot inside of any given compilation. But from an end user perspective, with Babel, there's only so much work you can do. SWC is like Babel, but written in Rust and about 20 times faster. There are various reasons why SWC is 20 times faster than Babel, but this speedup is mirrored in Parcel's implementation of SWC, where they're seeing 10 times speedup without Terser, which is the minification tool, and 3 times speedup with Terser. It's also worth mentioning that Terser is going through a re-implementation in Rust as well, inside of the SWC project. It's a bit of a port from the original JavaScript implementation. I assume that this means Parcel will just get these updates for free whenever they land in SWC, which is really nice. Although I don't have any insider knowledge on this, so if you're interested in that happening, follow the commits on the open source project for SWC and Parcel. SWC is now the default in Parcel 2, but this doesn't mean Babel is going away. If you're still using a Babel RC, Babel macros, or some CSS and JS, you probably still need Babel. So Parcel enables SWC by default, and Babel if you've configured it. This side-by-side approach is really nice, because it means that you can opt into the faster compilation times if you don't need these extra features that Babel provides. Additionally, projects like Vite have achieved great speedups in development server bootup time by reducing the amount of work that needs to happen when you boot up that server. Parcel 2 Beta 3 introduces a dash dash lazy flag for the development server that does something very similar and enables an on-demand compilation of any given page that you go to. The user experience being something like the development server boots much faster, then you go to a page which is on-demand compiled and slow on the first load. After the first load, however, if you navigate away and compile a different page and then navigate back, the load will be instant. And finally, another really interesting feature in Beta 3, at least for me, is the hot module reloading of Parcel plugins. This is exactly what it sounds like, in that Parcel plugins can now be developed without stopping the development server. It even includes support for tools like Patch Package, or directly modifying anything in your node modules. It works for Babel, PostCSS, and any other dev dependency your build depends on. Overall, I'm super excited to see more native tooling like SWC make its way into JavaScript projects. This is a trend I identified last year, and I'm excited to see it moving into the phase where it's being implemented in mainstream bundlers that haven't had this native tooling embedded in them previously.